What's up, everybody, and thanks for dropping into the Matrix. Now, this is part three, so I know y'all been anticipating this. So this is part three for animations and controls. And this is what I'm going to break down in this segment so y'all can see a little bit more stuff, okay? Now, with this segment right here, and I'm going to slow this down, okay, so y'all can actually see it. Y'all see that Tristan Thompson actually got that rebound. That is unacceptable. He's already boxed out. He got the rebound. Okay, so that's one thing that needs to be addressed. We already know that they're rebounding. In this segment that you see, and I'm going to slow it down, is that, now look at this. The defender is right there. He's just boring his way. There's no, there's no interaction or anything. That needs to be addressed as well. So the next segment that you see is actually the animation. So you'll actually see it here. Okay, those animations, that's not necessary to be in the game when you try to go for a layup. You see how he just grabbed the ball and then spin it like that? No, that particular animation, that needs to be addressed. It needs to come out. And as you see, the speed animation, something that you can't control. And then this animation where you can't control, where they automatically just run straight to the corner. You can't break out of this. It just keeps on going when you try to back out. And then you just have to shoot it out. That's something that needs to be addressed. That's a control issue. Here it goes again. Where you cannot control your player, it just keeps on going. Okay? And then it's, sometimes it's hard for you to catch up and get it out. Now, this play is where the defense is actually not looking. He's not looking. He turns around, and all of a sudden, his awareness is actually there. Now, remember, there's no awareness rated in the game. So that's something that needs to be addressed, is something with the awareness. Okay? This next play you want to see is the rebounding. Okay, now look at this sequence. Okay, now look at the sequence as you break it down. So as the sequence just keeps on going, you're going to see somebody get pushed. You see Gortatis there, you're going to see everybody, and somebody just get pushed out the way for the rebound. Okay, they automatically get pushed out of there for the rebound. Okay, on this segment. So I'm actually going to slow this one down because I'm going to show it a little bit more in detail as you see. So as you're looking at it, okay? So this is not really acceptable, so I'm going to slow it down, all right? So you see LeBron dribbling. The defender is on the side, so you really, really didn't do anything. He's not pushing. He's pushing him to the middle, okay? Now, he goes inside, and he goes up. Now, you're going to see, as he goes up, Gortatis in the play. You got all these Wizards in the play. Now, you're going to see where Dudley, which is number one, he has position. Now, look what happens when you see this. They all go up, but look, they push Dudley out the way because he has position for the rebound. That's not acceptable. They literally pushed him out the way through an animation where his body wasn't even respected. Okay? His body was not respected at all. It's just literally he gets pushed out the way. Okay? When you look at this. All right, as you're looking at it. That's why I'm slowing everything down so you can actually see it in its full frame. Okay, let's take a look again, and then this is going to be the sequence with LeBron, and then he's going to eventually he's going to score. But as that's going, as you're looking at this again, what I'm saying with all these sequences is that predicated animations and things that you cannot control. You know, and I understand everybody wants to get to the physics-based system, and that's where it needs to be. And that's where, the direction that they're trying to go, okay? And I know it's a process, but with these are mocap issues. These are things that need to be with mocap. These are things that need to be, with the mocap. And, they're doing that. But for as we know for right now, mocap is being is actually being done as we speak for 17. So when we go to this one, okay, getting back on defense is a must. This should not happen. Okay, look at all those Wizards back there. And he so happened to get back there. That should not happen. Okay, everybody should be looking at the ball. Look, you got guys looking, and you just got guys getting stopped. That should not happen. But he outblows the whole team. It's not an open court. He just literally outblow the team. Okay? Now, this sequence right here, how did he get this this rebound? Now, look at this. You got two Wizards, two big guys. They didn't even make an effort to go for the rebound. He just so happened to snatch it and fall in his place. Okay? He did a move. Nene is there. They didn't even try to go for a rebound. Again, rebounding needs to be addressed with all the animations. Now, This sequence is where I would say where that defensive line, where it picks up the guy, you're going to see Nene. They're going to put it there on Mo Williams. But then it switches. Then the guy, his man, supposed to pick up him. He does not. Okay? As you see, look, Nene backing up. You're in control. You try to stop, but it don't allow you. You're thinking that the guy, his man, supposed to pick up because it automatically switched. The defense needs to be addressed. As you see in this one, as you see the pick and roll game, look at this. Look at these animations in this sequence. Just look at the animations and look at it. Those need to be taken out. Look at this. Now they try to set a screen. He didn't set it. Then you try to drive to the basket. Look at this. That is not acceptable. That needs to be addressed. That needs to be polished and cleaned up. Look at it again. You see that? Can I get a foul? Exactly. So we're going to go to the next sequence. Free throws. This is something that I wanted to address and what I wanted to bring to the table with this. Now, Live 09's free throw sequence, which was actually respected, and this is what I've been trying to push for the longest. NBA Live 09's free throw was basically based off analytics. It was really, really based off the dynamic DNA. So when you actually shot a free throw, and even though it was a button press and you held it down, there was a meter that was at the top that actually did the actual percentages for the actual players with their percentages to make it realistic. And when you twitch with the controllers to make the controller shake and be erratic, the meter was erratic as well, where you really, really had to concentrate on your free throws, okay? That is something that needs to be in the game. That's something that the devs need to go ahead and look at that and bring back that feature. That is something that is very, 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 very good. So the next sequence is that what we want to take a look at is, all right, take a look at this sequence. Now look, Kyrie Irving is spinning around. The dude is going crazy. He throws up these crazy hook shots. Again, these hook shots and these shots need to be addressed. These particular animations with these control issues. He should never make that shot when he has big guys over him and he's almost at the top of the key. Okay, if it's like a Hail Mary or a throw up shot, that happens. But this happens constantly. And he's actually dribbling out of control and just to throw it up. And they put him in this animation. And that's the reason why I slowed this sequence down. So now I'm going to speed it back up so you'll actually see it again. So the next sequence is that this particular layup, this needs to get out. Okay, when it's back, that's not necessarily for Gortat to do that animation, just going backwards like that. You know, they do it at the wrong time where it don't need to be. This sequence here, okay, the grabbing of the steal is not a word, the passing or where the passing was soft. Okay, that would never happen. It should have been a two pass. Okay, this sequence right here is when the defender knocks the ball down and it still goes to the offensive player. You can't even react to get the ball. Look, knock it down. It goes straight to the offensive player when he already knocked it backwards, but it still goes to the offensive player. No, that's not acceptable. This one is an animation where you're going to the rim. Now take a look at this. You get bumped, but he dribbles. He double dribbles, picks the ball up, and go for a layup for the defense to catch up with him. That is not acceptable. Just look at it again at full speed. And it really should have been a foul because it's over the back. Okay? Again like this with the control issue with that. You pass it and you're still running. You see that? You're still running into the corner. Okay? You're still running to the corner and you cannot stop those. So I'm just letting you know on either side on which actually can go down. Now, play calling. Okay? As you see, the play calling is not going even though you go across the circle. Look at this again. The play calling does not initiate itself when you're going across or even near the circle. It doesn't even initiate. It just stands there. Okay? Now, this is a passing sequence where you pass the ball. It's supposed to be passing it to Green. It tried to pass it all the way to the defense. It always does that. Green is wide open. You try to pass to the right. That's a control issue. Next play. Okay? As you see, how he backs up that extra control. That's not good. The rebounding, that is a one-hand rebounding. Awareness needs to be respected in here with these rebounds, okay? So that's what needs to be respected, people, so y'all will actually see for yourself. That's not going to happen with Bogut or Tim Duncan. He would have actually got boxed out. I'll slow it down, and I'll let you see it again. As you see this, Bogut is coming across. Tim Duncan is at the top. Tim Duncan is not going to stand there. He's going to box him out. That's where awareness ratings need to be brought back in the game. Awareness is a very, very big thing that needs to be addressed. Okay? That will never happen. The next play. Okay? I'm running a play again. Okay? You're going to see this play. Okay? LaMarcus Aldridge just stands there. Take a look at this. Draymond Green takes it, but look at LaMarcus Aldridge and what he's doing. He's about to get in the post. Okay? Look, he doesn't make an effort. He just stands there. He's not even trying to get in the post. He's just standing there. You're anticipating him to get into the post. Look at this. I'm going to look at it again. Okay? He doesn't even make an effort. Okay? There's no effort in this. Look at this. The screener. That's supposed to be Tim Duncan. Now, look at this. That's a screener. You take a shot. But look at the screen. It wasn't initiated. Okay? And look at this again. Now, this is a control issue as well. You try to lay it up with Kawhi Leonard. The controls were not respond. We'll do it again. Tim Duncan is doing the wrong screen. He did not do the roll. He stood still, okay? He was supposed to roll to the basket, okay? Then Kawhi Leonard wasn't even looking for the steal. That needs to get taken out. You got to be looking and anticipating the steal, not looking away. It's like Cyclops action, okay? This is a animation where you just jump straight up in the air for no reason. Look at this. No reason whatsoever. Tim Duncan is just jumping up in the air for no reason. Okay? This is the next sequence where that Euro step, where it automatically does it in the wrong situation. It is not needed. The Euro step is not needed. All you have to do is just do a strong layup and go straight through, and his rating should be coming into effect with the layups and with the layups that you have. Okay? This one here, you're going to look. I am LaMarcus Aldridge. Now, look when you see the circle on LaMarcus Aldridge. Parker didn't even body him. He let him go through. But look at my body. I can't turn my guy around because of the controls. I cannot turn him around to even play defense to defend this action. So I would not be able to do it. Okay, y'all see that. The next sequence that you're going to see in here is this bump and crack that needs to be taken out. Y'all need to look at this. I'm going to show it again. Look. Look what he's doing. That's not in basketball. That's not necessary. That's an offensive foul that needs to be taken out. Look at this. Look at this. That's not acceptable. Even though he missed it, it's just the principle and the process. Look at this, the steal. He wasn't even looking at the ball, and he still stole it. He wasn't looking at nothing. He just took the ball. Look at that. And again, like I always say, people, it's like when it comes down to mechanics and it comes down to the dribbling, when it comes down to smooth animations, when it comes down to everything and what we need, these two installments are the ones that are the ground and the foundation for this. NBA Live 08 and NBA Live 10. In NBA Live 08, the dribbling mechanics were phenomenal. The response time and control was phenomenal. Okay. It also had signature in NBA Live 08. It also has signature in NBA Live 10. So they actually had mocap in these two installments. I never said go back and take stuff. You take certain elements from these games and you apply them, but you just improve them and you put these into the game. Okay, I could break that a little bit more down in another segment on what I mean, or I might do it in a live stream for everyone so y'all can actually see for yourself. But these two games, okay, along with NBA Live 09, they are pinnacles that are in the NBA Live game franchise that need to take these installments, and a lot of installments that was presented in the game. And we all know, as a live community, the NBA Elite 11 had a lot of good points in it that y'all still want to use. And we already know that NBA Elite 11 is some of the foundation that y'all want to use, because some of the components that was in NBA Elite 11 were very, very, very good ideas. Okay? They were very, very good ideas. So we know that that's the direction with the fixes and everything y'all trying to do. Now, this sequence in this game, okay, if you're looking at this, and I'm going to slow this down, okay? He goes up, and look at that. The body is not even respected. But they're going to call this foul on the gentleman. He's just going up, but it's pushing him back. Okay? is pushing him back. When you look at this in slow motion, okay? I'll show it again, and you can see it in fast motion. He goes. He don't get stopped. The game just automatically pushes him back with an offensive foul. You can't do that, okay? Okay, now look at this sequence, all right? And you actually see what I'm talking about in this sequence. The rebounding, again. Animations that are not necessary. I'm going to show it to you again. You're going to see the erraticness. He tried to go for a rebound, and look. It goes on the ground. That's not necessary. No, that does not go. Now we're going to do a play calling situation. Now you see where the screener was supposed to be? It did not go. Look at this again. You see where the screener was supposed to go? And the play calling takes too long to initiate. Okay? It does not develop and follow through fast enough. Okay? As you see that. Okay? The next play is this. All right? Rebounding of the ball. Look at this. You're going to see. Okay? You're absolutely going to see. The next sequence is going to be this. That lob sequence, that should never have happened, because that's where awareness needs to come into play. He's playing a zone. Now, why did the guy on the far end go for the lob instead of the guy that's right there on the side? You got Parry and you got Monroe, and they move, but Gollins is the one that comes over. That's not acceptable. Awareness needs to be respected. Look, I'm going to go ahead and slow this down so you'll actually see it. You see Parker, nobody's guarding him. You can lob that up straight to them, but the guy on the end comes. Even though the play was initiated, okay, they should break out that play because you make the lob. It should be awareness. Here you go again with these fast breaks and the passing again. When you have guys back and they're looking, you see a guy, you'll see Giannis, number 34, he's looking. He's looking at the guy, but they actually make him turn. Look, you will see him looking. Durant is going to go right by him. They should sprint all the way back, but they make him turn around. That's not acceptable. So he cannot see the ball, okay? It's not balanced, okay? They'll steal the ball when they're not looking, but they're not going to allow you to, when you're already looking at the play, they make you turn around, then you can't control it to be able to deflect the ball or to steal it. This play right here is the play, it's the infamous play where you shoot and you try to stop in a spot, but it makes you go forward. Okay, look, I go around, but the momentum makes me go, and then it still makes me jump up forward. No, that animation needs to get taken out. I didn't even move. It's nothing momentum there. I just had to move over and go to a spot. And just makes you jump forward. That makes you look, you literally jump into the defense, people. You literally jump into the defense. This next sequence here, and I want to slow this down so everybody can see this. So take a look. I want everybody to take a look at this sequence. He went for a Euro step in the defense and, you know, with the body. Now, this one is a pass. It was supposed to go to Monroe. Look what it made me pass it to. It made me pass to the wrong guy. You can't do that. It was supposed to go to Monroe because he's sitting right there, but my momentum and the animation made me go forward, and it put it passed to the guy. This one is a pick and roll. When you see this, I'm trying to go to the roller. It made me pass to the wrong guy with the freestyle passing. That's why I said the freestyle passing don't work. I wanted to go to the roller. It made me go to the wrong guy. This right here is a rebounding sequence. Again, you will actually pay attention to it, and you'll see how it develops and how it all pans down. Okay? And I didn't slow this down because it's a long clip, and you'll see the sequence. There is no effort. They don't make an effort to go for the rebound. I'll show it to you again. He goes up. He should have got the rebound. There's no effort. Look at the sequence on what it is. You got two guys there. He's already boxed out. Look, he's boxed out. How does he get the board? The guy's going to get the rebound. How is he going to get the rebound? They have no one there. He's out. Look, how does he get that? You got two guys there. Okay? That is not acceptable. Look, I'm going to go ahead and I'll put it in slow motion for everybody. He gets bumped. He's already boxed out. You see the guy on the left? He's boxed out. He didn't even make an attempt to go get the ball. He's just standing there locked in the animation. That's not acceptable. He's locked in the animation. You're looking at it, okay? He passes the ball up. He passes the ball back out. And remember, people, I always say this, and I say this on my streams. You don't know when a game is really, really messed up until you play another user. When you play head-to-head and you play an actual user, that's when you find out what the issues are when you play a user. You're not going to really find out this stuff when you play the computer, because the computer is already programmed to do what it needs to do, okay? But when you play an actual user, that is when you find out all the issues and all the problems. It could be in person or it can be online. And as you see, as you're looking at this, you're going to see all the mishaps with the rebounding and what's going on. When you look at this sequence with the screener, now look at this, okay? There's two guys on the screener locked in an animation, but he doesn't do anything. I'm the guy in the circle. They don't even allow the dude to come over to trap the screen. That's what I call, okay? Now, he goes up. You got two Bucks there. How does he even get the ball? I understand he went up, but they didn't even try to make an effort for them to go back up to go get the rebound. So what I'm saying is that the effort and the awareness needs to be addressed, and that's what needs to be done, you know, because they got to have an awareness rating to get this done. Now, this player is really, really tripped out because he was literally boxed out. I'll slow it down for you. He's going to shoot the ball. Now, Monroe was standing there. Just look at him. He's on the right. He's not even doing anything. He's just standing there. That's not acceptable. You have to try to attempt to go for the rebound. Look at that. He's just standing there. He's not even trying to do anything. He's just standing there. And they would not let me switch because you saw me with the other guy. Now, this is a block that really wasn't a block. It was really a goaltend. They call goaltending, but they don't call it. That's why I say the rules need to be in this game. They need to put the rules in the game where they are actually called, because they don't call fouls. There's no elite. There's no goaltending all there like that, and it's goaltending a lot. That's a block from an animation. That should have not been a block. It was a goaltend. This right here was an animation where I got around him, but the animation led me into the defense. All I had to do was just lay it up in that spot. I've already passed the defender. Look, the animation led me into the defense because of that spin. No, you should. That's not acceptable. Okay. Now, this is the this animation with that Euro step. I didn't do a Euro step. It's an animation that allows you to do it. I went on the other side. That's a goaltend. I went on the other side. That is a goaltend. Now, this play is, now when you're looking at this, you see him getting pushed back. You see him in the animation getting pushed back. Look, he get pushed and he just slides. Now, this play is a rebounding sequence. Now, check this out. He shoots it up. Now, you're going to see he is boxed out. Then all of a sudden, they made him warp straight through him. And then he gets the rebound. That needs to be addressed. Just warping and all this morphing, that needs to be addressed, especially when it's supposed to be a physics-based game. Okay? Now, the pass, this is this dang animation stuff on these layups that's not necessary. You pass the ball, all this spinning, all this up and under stuff, that's not necessary. All you got to do is go straight up for a layup. Look, pass it. And this is how the defense catches up, because you get stuck in the animation. There's nothing you can do about it. Once you press it, it goes in that sequence. Right here, this is out of control, as you're going to see. And Jabari Parker should have got that steal, but where does it go? It goes right back to the guy's hands. It goes right back into his hands as you look at this. He's already locked up. Jabari Parker has him locked up. And there's no need for this to be going on, people. He's already on him once he goes around. You see when he attaches himself on him, he has Durant in the corner. But he's going to make a bad pass. And on top of that, Jabari Parker is looking. He's aware. He's supposed to be able to get that. But they get you in an animation and you cannot control this. All right, y'all. Well, I'm about to go ahead and end this. If you know, you know. But if you didn't know, you know your boy Prime always got you. All the time, NBA Live. And the development team, please, let's just be aware of this. Because we are the main ones. We are the community. You know, and we're the ones with the voice, and I'm one of the main voices and the strong voice. All right, y'all. Thanks for dropping in for this segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. I'm glad you could join me, and hit me up next time. All right, y'all. I'm Ghost. Peace.